Well, it's 6:35 on Saturday, 6:11. And now I know these sheriff's deputies have got to burr up their ass about me in particular. One of them just drove by, and while he was behind the coach, he blips his siren, you know, whoop! How he hit it, just a little notice. And there's nothing going on. You know, not like somebody was in the street or a car was in his way or anything. Just as he was going by me, whoop, gave me a little hoot, a little toot. So there's another, that's the fifth incident. Had an incident at Las Tunas Beach a couple weeks ago, 9 a.m. Second incident was them banging on the vehicle, vandalizing my vehicle about 2:30 in the morning about a week ago. Then you had the night before where they snuck up and put tickets on everybody's vehicles, but not the millions of others, supposedly in violation of 1664.060. You can't park anywhere 2 to 4 a.m. anywhere in Los Angeles County with millions, probably a million miles of road, who knows, hundreds of thousands of miles possibly, roads, alleys, everything, and millions of cars all parked illegally 2 to 4 a.m. not being moved every half hour. And then, just yesterday, another incident where they were in cahoots, I believe, with this guy in the green. Somebody just pulled in front of me. The guy in the green RV up there. Or somebody is filing false complaints. Or it could be somebody else that just went by this morning on a bike, kind of laughing and saying, what did he say? Whack, whack, $50 whack. You know, like, whack, whack, you know. And there's some yuppie scum on a bike. And I thought, how does he know that I was ticketed for a $50 ticket about, like, the night before? Unless, of course, he's the guy that called and made a false complaint. So somebody out here is making false complaints almost on a daily basis suddenly. As soon as I come down here, I understand that some of these guys have been down here parking for years, and never been hassled. Maybe because they're fucking crazy or eccentric, like this guy in the green RV who's screaming the other day. Anyway, and then that was fourth, where these sheriff's deputies came and harassed me. I got that on video. And then just now, a sheriff's deputy driving by and for no apparent reason whatsoever hit his siren and drove past. Unfortunately, I didn't get the camera on in time, but I do have him on camera on the side, which has a timestamp. So I'm going to download that, print that image out. I'll have a timestamp of his car going by at that very moment. There's a young lady in shorts. Look at her. You won't be able to see her on this camera. It sucks. Shorts and leggings and... that would be five incidents. I think that constitutes a basis for a lawsuit for $25,000 plus damages under the California and U.S. codes. So the next time one of them approaches me, I'm going to inform him that he's getting sued. He or she is getting sued. Because I've just about had it with these people. I have no idea why they've decided to begin this vendetta against me, other than, you know, they got their two or three wacko lunatics that live down here and get away with it night after night. And they've been looking the other way, which is discriminatory again, you know. So I have to be I have to be insane or, you know, living on the dole in order to not be fucking fucked with. Jesus. Anyway. So, that's that, yeah. I'll check the camera and get an image of the cop car going by. Unfortunately, there's no sound on it, so, you know, I could be lying about the whoop, but It's all right. It's my word.